Let's say that the current market settlement price for a futures contract that specifies the delivery of 1,000 pounds of apples on October 20th. And just for the simplicity of the math in this example, let's assume that that is 1 year away. And the current settlement price, the current market price on the future exchange for delivery on that date is $300. Let's also assume that the current market price, so if you were to buy or sell apples today, not on October 20th, which is a year away, but today, let's assume that the current market price is $200. Let's also assume that if you were to take out a $200 loan, that you would have to pay 10% interest. So if you were to borrow $200 today, you would essentially have to pay back $220 in a year. Now, given all of the parameters that I've set up, is there a way to make risk-free profit? Is there a way to kind of arbitrage this situation? And as you can imagine, there is. And what we can do is we can borrow $200. Let me list it all out. We can borrow $200. Borrow $200 and then use that $200 to buy 1,000 pounds of apples. So then we buy 1,000 pounds of apples. We keep them in our garage or someplace like that. And then we also sell, or I guess we could say we become the seller on this futures contract, or we sell the futures short, I guess is another way to think about it. So we also become the seller on the futures contract. On the futures contract. So essentially we are agreeing to sell 1,000 pounds of apples on October 20th, a year from now, for $300. So what I want to show you is if we set it up this way, we are guaranteed to make money no matter what happens to the price of apples. And that's why we're calling it an arbitrage. Because if you fast forward 1 year, so let's fast forward 1 year. So in 1 year, we definitely have 1,000 pounds of apples. And just for the sake of simplicity, let's assume that apples don't get bad, that I've somehow freeze-dried them, or I don't know. These are apples that never spoil. So let's say a year from now, I have the 1,000 pounds of apples. So I give the apples to settle the futures contract. Give apples to settle the contract. And then, of course, I have my loan. I have my loan of $200. But guess what? When I settled the contract, when I settled the futures contract, I got $300. So I get $300. And what do I owe? Well, I owe $220 on my loan. So let me subtract that out. So I owe $220. And so I made a guaranteed, risk-free $80 of profit in 1 year. And we're not thinking about how much money I might have had to set aside for margin, but this is essentially just free money. And if you think about it, if this settlement price is anything, if the settlement price is anything above the $220, then I'm going to make a risk-free profit. So one way to think about futures pricing is even if you think there's going to be a cold snap and apples are going to disappear and there's going to be this shortage of apples, and so you might say, hey, maybe the apple prices will go up a year ago, there's always going to be a way to arbitrage it if the settlement price, if the growth in price is more than the cost of borrowing the same amount of money, the cost of borrowing $200. So in this situation, the cost of borrowing is $20. So the settlement price really shouldn't be, if we assume that there's no arbitrage opportunities, it really shouldn't be more than $220.